Leo kind of just left, and he's been kind of weird.
Because he pretty much came back from NorCal and picked up all of his stuff. He is going to be living with Louie from now on. If you guys remember...
Hey, Honda amigos, welcome back to the channel. So today it's not really a wrenching video, it's not really an adventure video. I'm just gonna be talking. We're gonna be talking about something that I've seen floating around the internet, just kind of rumors or thoughts that or opinions that people have formulated because of stuff they've seen, stuff they've heard, and we're just gonna clear the air out and we're gonna talk about it. So hope you guys enjoy this and hopefully get some of your questions answered. Quiet on set. But anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoy this one. Like I said, if you do have any further questions, comments, or concerns about whatever we're gonna talk about on this video, please do head to the comment section. If not, my DMs are always open on Instagram. And with that being said, so guys, the topic for today's video is going to be covering why a lot of you guys have not seen me appear on a certain channel. So in order to even begin talking about, you know, the main reason or the main events that occurred to that ultimatum, well, we have to cover where it all started, where it all began, how it was that I came about, you know, living in SoCal and going on all of these adventures. This is my 1990 Honda CRX SI. I bought this from an older lady a while back. When I bought it, it definitely had a lot of issues. It wasn't the car you guys have come to know now. And well, the reason I mentioned that is because ever since I've owned this car pretty much, I've always had issues. I've always encountered engine issues or drivetrain issues and stuff like that. And we come to a point where I got my car running and Nate gets introduced into my life. This was midsummer when he comes up to NorCal to buy a CRX. I had just finished putting mine back on the road. I had finished my first swap, which you can actually see on my YouTube channel. I did that, and then I met this guy. Came up, sold him CRX parts, and we stayed in touch since. After that, I saw a pretty good deal come up on some CRX seats. And between the point where I met him, first met him, to me delivering those seats, the CRX that he had bought actually got crashed. He wrecked it and bought a second shell, which is the one you guys have seen me work on with him and help him restore. So when I took down the seats, was probably somewhere in July, late August, probably a little bit later. And when I took down the seats, we had agreed on getting cash on delivery. But I should have known then that, you know, this guy was probably, you know, not fully fully there with his word, because when I showed up with the seats, no cash was ready for me. But that's not the point of this story. That's just, you know, one of those little details that you just got to keep in the back of your mind as we progress. So once the seats were delivered, like I mentioned, we kept in touch. I came back up to NorCal after dropping off those seats and my engine blew. I blew a hole in it. And thankfully, to my aunt, I was able to work on my car there. and I had no other plans. I had no money. I was pretty much on a dead end. I wasn't able to acquire an engine or anything like that at the moment, because any person that I knew related to, you know, pretty much the Honda game, you can call it, had at that point already departed from my life. And well, Nate, having seen that I was in need of an engine, he reached out to me and offered me an engine. And bear in mind, like I said, I didn't ask him, I didn't reach out to him or anything. He's the one that offered it. So, like I said, having no other option, I took it.
But yeah, guys, he offered me an engine. And like I said, I'm in NorCal, he's in SoCal. And what his plan was he was gonna come with his friend. His friend was gonna help him tow the engine, tow all the tools, and they were gonna come up and give me a hand, swap it overnight or however long it took. You know, they were gonna have the availability to come out and give me a hand. So of course, like I said, I accepted it. I said, why not? You know, if you're willing to do so, I'll do my best to welcome you and accommodate you at, you know, my where I was living at the moment, which bear in mind, I was living in a van. You can go on his channel actually, and you can see a clip of him waking up in my van one of those mornings that he was there, that he was here helping me. So, you know, I'm not pulling this out of thin air. These are events that actually occurred. So guys, the reason why he came up by himself was because his friend, his pal, wasn't able to help him. So what ended up happening was he took a bus up to NorCal and we pulled a mission. As you guys saw on his channel, we went to pick and pull, we pulled an engine, and throughout this whole thing, like I said, he stayed in my van. At the moment I was living with my aunt, crashing on her couch, but also living in my van because they don't have the room for me. You know, they're in a very small apartment and I'm just kind of extra there. And that's the reality of it. You know, I'm here by myself. I don't have a mom, I don't have a dad, I don't have a grandparent or, you know, family that have space to accommodate me. And that's okay, because I keep doing my thing. You know, day by day we grind and we go and get what we want, right? So back to the story. We pull the engine, we find out it's bad, and at this point we have no option. I gotta take Nate back to LA because he has to go back to his family, and I'm getting told by my uncle, like, hey, you have a car in Jackson in my driveway, can you please get it out? So that's what we did. We got out of the driveway and we drove down to SoCal. Like I said, Nate offered me an engine, but when he came he couldn't bring it. So what I did was, one, I took Nate back home to SoCal, and two, I went to go pick up that engine he offered, because as you guys saw on his channel, he posted it as well. We went ahead and put in the $20 engine I bought for parts from my friend Armando, drove that to SoCal to then put the engine that he offered me at the beginning. So we worked that out. That wasn't the end of it. So you guys know, we got that engine running, had a lot of issues. Was going back and forth between exhaust systems and whatnot. And at the same time that all of this was going on, I was also, like I said, just trying to get my livelihood going, trying to, you know, establish my life. And well, that on top of having to also, how would I say, having to assist Nate, because not only did he not have a car, he also didn't have the support from his family to be able to take one of their cars and go on all of these adventures. You know, go drive to Oregon, pick up a dashboard, go to San Diego, pick up parts, you know, drive to LA, middle of the night, stuff like that. Just try to give him a hand with that. And not only was I helping him that way, but I also wanted to help his family. I was paying them rent. I wasn't just freeloading off of them. Ever since, like I mentioned, since we got the engine in, I moved back to pick up my stuff after I dropped them off. And that's when I, you know, quote unquote, moved in, which was December. So from December to then early in the summer, right before August, was when I was staying with him. And throughout the months, I was, you know, always on time, paying my rent to them. And I would always help his mom. Yeah. Nate doesn't talk a lot about his mom. I don't know why. I mean, she's, you know, she definitely helps him out a lot. And I feel personally that the way he treats her is not the best. I mean, I'm not one to talk because, like I said, I don't have my mother with me, but I for sure would not call her the B word. I would for sure not disrespect her in any way. And guys, you guys saw, when he got the free RX, where did he put it? He put it in the storage unit that I rented out with his mom. Sketch ass deal, because first and foremost, like, his mom was, you know, doing a lot of loopholes in order to let us be there. And then the fact that we brought in cars didn't help the cause. So I would help his mom clean up that space in exchange for her letting us leave the cars there, and on top of paying rent for the space, on top of the rent that I was already paying his family to let me sleep on their floor. And guys, there's just, I could spend probably, you know, the next couple of hours just going detail by detail, further into detail of, you know, how this guy lives, how, you know, he can't even make his own bed, or how they wash his dishes, how, you know, et cetera, et cetera. Like, that's not what this is about. This is just to let you guys know that I did my part. You know, while I was down there, I didn't just be there, because one of the main reasons why I moved in was because, just like Nate offered me an engine, he offered me to move in. And in exchange, I offered to help him with the CRX. That's why you guys saw me drive with him everywhere, pick up every part. When he wanted to paint his CRX, he wanted to buy a compressor. And guess who helped him buy the compressor? Guess who took him to buy the compressor? You know, I wasn't just there to be stagnant, to just, as some of you have said it, freeload and bum off of him. I was actually helping the guy out. When he was at work, when he worked earlier in the year, I would be at his house working on the CRX while he was gone, trying to make him make progress and get his goal achieved. When we painted the CRX, I was there with him. When he wanted to go pick up the swap, I was the one that drove with him to pick it up. And guys, it, at the moment, like I said, it felt right, because he was helping me out in such a big way, because I didn't have anywhere to live. Like I said, I was in my van, and after I dropped Nate off, my plan was move back up to NorCal and just live with my CRX in my van. But like I said, he said, stay in my house, my family, you know, will be glad to support you. And I'm thankful for that. You know, I thank them and I appreciate them. But if we skip forward to about a month before I decided to leave, well, it wasn't even I decided to leave. It was the actions that he took that I respected, that he made. That's what led me to leave. So, as you guys know, he had the dual overhead cam CC in his car. Well, as we all saw, his water pump started failing, and instead of fixing the water pump, he decided to take out the block. Now, if you ask any logical person what to do when the water pump goes out, I don't think replacing the whole engine block is first on the list. Not my car. But he goes ahead and takes out the block and puts in a new one. He puts in the D16C6 that he had originally offered, the one that I went down to SoCal with him for the first time to put in my CRX as my engine. So he goes ahead and puts that in, but then he also goes ahead and complains to me about how I wasn't responsible enough to take care of the engine and the issues that it had. Bear in mind, he did post a video called Leo Gets State Reft, and in that video is when we actually took that engine out. Why did we take it out? Well, because he wanted his CCU back. That's the only reason we took it out. I was working at the time, and I wasn't able to afford to go get my exhaust fixed or to get a proper tune to have my car running right. So Nate's solution to that issue was, I need my ECU back. Here's a whole block. Let's take it out, put it in, and I can have my ECU back. And when we did all that, we also had issues come up. And he wasn't happy for those issues either. And neither was I, because like I said, I was just about to get paid, so I was just about to handle those issues, but for some reason, he was just desperate and wanted CCU back. By all means, you know, I gave it back to him. But we keep progressing, and as you guys saw in a lot of the videos, I stopped showing up because I was working. I was working full time. I was doing 10, 12 hours with my friend Louie, who thankfully to him, I was able to get a job as a welder. And you know, he taught me everything up to now that I know of welding, and I'm thankful for that. Thank you, Louie. Like, man, you came through, because those are skills that I'll keep and cherish for the rest of my life, and they'll take me to wherever, you know, I want to go next. But anyways, guys, that's what was going on. I was coming back home late, and as you guys saw, Nate TRX just kept having issues. And I kept wanting to help him, but with only 3 hours to either sleep, live, or, you know, do whatever I wanted and then go back to work right after, like, I wasn't able to really be as much of a help as he wanted me to. And that's when we come to the week of when he made his decision. So up to this point, Nate had been telling me, like, hey man, like, we're gonna get our own spa, like, we're gonna start saving, like, we should really start looking into moving out. And by all means, I was with it. I was telling him, I was like, look man, like, I have a job, like, I'm working, you're unemployed, like, I don't know what your plan is, but I'm getting money, I'm working towards that plan of getting a spot. And like I said, I didn't see anything from him. I didn't see him get a job. I didn't see him push any effort towards that. I mean, I saw him working on his car, but it wasn't the same. And I tried my best. I was working. And then one of these days that I'm working, I come to find out that he not only was trying to get rid of my stuff, but he was giving it away. He decided to go on Instagram and give my stuff away. So me being at work and then clocking out, seeing this online, it didn't sit well with me. So thankfully to the homie Louie, he was there and he helped me go pick up my stuff and pretty much move into the shop that I was working at, because he wasn't living in his own spot either. You know, he had his own life issues going on. And then this happened to me, and Louie, just being the good friend he is, he wanted to help me out as well. So like I mentioned, he was able to help me move into the shop where we were working at, and I was there for a while. But guys, nothing lasts forever, and life happens. We live and we learn. So I was with Louie for a while, and after that, I decided that it was time to come back to NorCal. Apart from the fact that I had already been down in SoCal for about 7-8 months, it was time to come handle business. It was time to come back to reality. I've had a lot of issues, not like health issues, but more so legal matters that I wanted to take care of, that I had needed to take care of. So that's what I did. I came back and I've been dealing with that. I got a job and I've been going full time. And thankfully, well, I talked things out with my aunt, and she's been a lot of help, as well as many of my other friends. So anytime I can, I do stop by and I visit Dana on my way back home from work, and we get to wrench.
You're more than welcome to be here, bro. And no, Leo's not sleeping on the couch. So chill the fuck out.
Yeah, guys. You guys did see as well. We went ahead and swapped in the B16A that Dana got and the giveaway CRX. And like I said, I don't like having dues, so I paid the man. And that engine's mine now. So definitely stick around for what's to come with that, guys. Like I said, today's video is just a talking video. Just wanted to, you know, mention some of the facts that have occurred of certain events and, you know, let everybody know.
Tell me how much I missed that hole.
Man.
Punched the wrong freaking hole. Make the lie step.